Are you unable to delete files from your external hard drive on your Windows computer? If so, this guide will help you resolve the issue. This is the Windows Club. You can easily delete files from your external hard drive. Just open File Explorer, open your external drive, right-click on files and folders you want to erase, and select the delete option. Or select all the files and hit the delete button on your keyboard. If you're unable to delete some files and folders from your external hard drive, let's get started on how to resolve the issue. Method 1. Make sure the file is not used by another process. The file you cannot delete might be in use by another process. So ensure the file is not in use and then try deleting it. To do this, you can take the help of the resource monitor. It is an inbuilt Windows app to identify the process or service locking a file. Open Run app by pressing Windows plus R hotkey and then type resmon in it. Press the OK button and resource monitor will open up. In the resource monitor window, go to the CPU tab and expand the associated handles option. Now in the search box, type the name of the file that is showing logged by a process and press enter button. It will show you a list of processes holding the target file. You can right-click on the process and select the end process option to end it. After the process ends, try performing the action you wanted to on the previously logged file. Method 2. Take ownership of the problematic file or folder. This issue might be caused because of permission issues with the target file or folder. So the first thing you can do is take ownership of the files and folders you cannot delete and see if the issue is fixed. Press Win plus E to open File Explorer and move to the external drive with which you are experiencing the issue. Now right-click on the problematic file or folder from the context menu and click on Properties. In the Properties window, navigate to the Security tab and click on the Edit button present below. Click on the Add button in the new window. Next, enter authenticated users inside the Enter the object name to select box and press the OK button. Select the authenticated user's name and then tick the Allow checkbox present next to Full Control. Once done, click on the Apply, then OK button to save changes. You can now try deleting the files from the external drive and check if the problem is resolved. Method 3. Run the chkdsk command. You can use the chkdsk utility command to repair drive errors. Type cmd in the Windows search and select to run it as an administrator. Now enter chkdsk /F/R in the elevated CMD window and press enter. In the above command, the letter C represents the drive letter on which you perform the disk check command. So replace it with your external hard drive letter. Once the command is finished, you can try deleting files from your external hard drive and check if the problem is fixed. Method 4. Remove write protection on your external hard drive. If you're still unable to delete files from your external drive, it may be because your external hard drive is write protected. So remove write protection from your external drive using the Windows built-in command line disk management tool called diskpart. Open command prompt with admin rights. Now type diskpart and press enter. Next, enter these commands one by one and press enter each time. List space disk. Select disk 2. Replace 2 with the disk number of your external hard drive. Now type attributes disk clear read only command to remove write protection from the drive and press enter. When done, you can check if the issue is fixed. Method 5. Connect the hard drive to another computer and check if it helps. In case the issue persists, you can try connecting your external hard drive to another computer and see if you can clear unwanted files and folders. Method 6. Try using a third-party file deletion software. There might be some stubborn files on your external hard drive that cannot be removed by the normal deletion method. So you can use third-party file deletion software to delete unwanted files and folders from drives. There are some good free file deletion software including Free File Unlocker, Teaser Unlocker, Imco Unlock It, Delete Doctor, Wise Force Deleter and Unlocker that you can use. Method 7. Format your external hard drive. Your hard drive might be corrupted beyond repair and thus you cannot modify files. So format your external hard drive. Do note that formatting the drive will clear all your data stored in it. So if there are some necessary files that you don't want to lose, create a backup of them in another drive before you proceed with the formatting process. First, you need to plug in your external hard drive or pen drive in your computer. After that, press Win plus X and select Terminal. Type Get Disk and press Enter. Find the name of your external hard drive in the Friendly Name column. Also, you need to note down the number of the hard disk. To initiate the process, type Clear Disk hyphen number 2 hyphen Remove Data and press Enter. Replace the number 2 with the original number that is assigned to your drive. Once done, you should get a confirmation message. Type Y and hit the Enter button. Wait till the process completes. Now type New Partition hyphen Disk Number 2 hyphen Use Maximum Size hyphen Is Active hyphen Drive Letter Z command and press Enter. It will create a new partition. Here, number 2 represents the drive that you formatted earlier and Z represents the drive letter that will be assigned to the external hard drive or USB drive. You can replace them accordingly. After entering that command, a pop-up will appear to format your disk. You can use that pop-up window option. Or you can use format-volume-drive-letter-z-file-system-fat32-new-file-system-level-usb command. If you want to format the drive in the FAT32 file system, you need to choose that in the command. If you use the NTFS file system, the command should be format-volume-drive-letter-z-file-system-NTFS-new-file-system-label-usb. If you choose NTFS, it might take a couple of more seconds than FAT32. Once done, you should be able to use the external hard drive or USB drive regularly. So that's it. Subscribe to the Windows Club for all your tech solutions related to Windows. Thanks for watching.